Hello everyone and welcome to New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host Richard Evans. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. All right, today I'd like to show you how to use the TriCaster control panel to control the mix effect, positioning, and editing of your shots. Now this can be used for both controlling shots in multiple layer mix effects or virtual sets. Super convenient, so let's dive in and take a look. All right, so we're going to start off in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and let me show you how to adjust the positions of your different mix effects or virtual set shots within the interface before I move over to the control panel side of things. All right, so I'm going to be working with my mix effect number 2, which I currently have punched up on my program output, so we can take a look at it. And then over here on the interface, this particular virtual set that I'm in right now only has 2 different inputs to work with. So I have my input number 2, which is my host on a green screen, which I have keyed out. And then I also have that New Tech logo in the background, which is over here on buffer number 2. All right, so if I wanted to adjust that shot, so for example, you can see that his desk is right here, so I have these papers and I want to get those out of the way because it looks kind of weird. So I want to go ahead and push him a little bit down so that I don't see those papers on his desk. So to do that, let's go ahead and click on the positioning tool on my layer A and turn on the positioning function here. And then I have access to all of these different controls, my position, zoom, rotation, cropping, etc. So let's go ahead and just use my mouse to then position him down a little bit. So I'll just use that, drag it down. You can see there he goes. And now those papers are out of the shot, looking pretty good. I can also zoom that shot in and out, make him gigantic, or make them smaller, depending on how I want to do this. So that looks pretty decent there. I can even adjust the rotations. If I want to flip them on his x-axis, I can do that. Or y-axis, z-axis, however you want to do this here. I mean, obviously that looks kind of weird for this particular shot, but who knows what kind of shots you're working with here. And then I can also adjust the cropping. So the left side of it, cut off half of it. Also the top, so I can cut his head off if I want to do that. And then the bottom, and right, etc. So kind of a quick little overview of doing that. Now I also have a positioning tool in my layer B, so I'll go ahead and turn that on, and then I can adjust the zoom of that shot, make that New Tech logo bigger, smaller, etc. All right, or just hit reset, put it back to normal. All right, so now let's move over to the control panel side of things and show you how to do that. All right, so here is the TriCaster 2-stripe control panel that I'm working with here. And there's a few different ways that we can then assign what we want to be controlled by our control surface. So the positioning, etc., is pretty much going to be affected by this top right section, but we're going to need to tell this top right section what we want to be controlling. So there's 2 different ways of doing that. I can either assign the stripe that I want to use to control that. So for example, I'm on mix effect number 2 right now, so I want to assign my top stripe to mix effect number 2. And again, to review to do that, I'll hold down delegate stripe and then press mix effect 2. And now this top stripe is my mix effect number 2. Now, to tell this top right portion here of what I want to control, I can either click on follow stripe, which is over here in the top. Let me go ahead and zoom into that real quick so you can see. All right, so I can either hit follow stripe, so then that will then be permanently assigned to whatever I have on my top stripe here, or I can just type in, punch up the mix effect that I want to use. So I'm just going to hit number 2 since I'm working on mix effect number 2, and so it's kind of up to you how you want to set that up. All right, so we're on mix effect number 2, so now what we want to do is let's move the positioning of our layer A, which is our host on his virtual set, to a different part of the screen. So to do that, you would just use one of these 4 up here at the top. So we have 4 different layers to choose from. Of course, on this particular virtual set, I only have 2 sources to work with. So we'll press A, and now I am able to manipulate that particular shot. Now I have these 3 buttons here to choose from, my positioning and scale, rotation, and crop, to then adjust that particular shot. So let's say that we want to move our host a little bit closer to that TV over there. So we can use our joystick, and then I can move him left and right, up and down, etc. So let's move him over here. Do, 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 do. There we go. And now he's right next to that screen. I can also adjust his rotation from here by clicking on ROT and then either turning my joystick clockwise, counterclockwise, up and down, Z-axis, etc. Again, that looks kind of weird, so we'll hit reset, and that will reset only the rotation side of things, won't adjust the positioning and scale, so that's kind of convenient. And then I can also adjust the cropping here, so if I move over to the right, you'll see that I am adjusting the left crop, and if I hold down the button on this joystick, I can then adjust the right side, so it'll take the opposite side. And then if I move down, that will adjust the top cropping. And if I hold down the button, it'll adjust the bottom cropping. All right, cool. So that's looking pretty good. All right, so now let's go ahead and adjust that screen that is on his virtual set. So that is layer B. And if I click layer B here, boop. Now I can adjust again the positioning, rotation, and cropping of that shot. So let's go ahead and just scale that up a little bit so that NewTek logo is pretty big on screen. Cool. And then I can adjust the rotation here, etc. And let me just reset that and adjust the cropping. So pretty much the exact same controls that I was using for my A layer. All right, so that's just using this for the virtual set side of things. Now, let's say that we want to do something a little bit different. Let me jump back over to my interface real quick, and I'm going to punch up my mix effect number 3, and let's bring that up to my program. So I have currently 4 different shots on this particular mix effect that I'm working with. You can make it a 2-layer, 3-layer, 4-layer, etc. All right, so I just have my inputs 3, 4, 5, 6 layered up here, and it looks like I only have 1 shot here, but that's because these are all maximized and sitting on top of each other. So we want to adjust those by using what we did before. So again, let's go ahead and instead of saying follow stripe, because I'm currently assigned to my mix effect number 2 on that stripe, I can either reset that, but to make it easier on ourselves, I can just hit 3, and now I am on my mix effect 3. So now what I want to do is I am going to grab my A layer here, and let's adjust the positioning of that. So let's go ahead and scale her down a little bit, do it that way, and check it out. So now my A shot is a little bit smaller, and now I can move that around screen. So let's say we'll put her in the top left. We'll do a little Brady Bunch effect here kind of thing. All right, now this is going to take a little bit to manipulate here, and I won't waste your time as I try to get this perfect. So let's just kind of do this a little messy. And now let's go ahead and grab our layer B, and we'll do the same thing. We'll scale them down, put them in the top right corner here. And again, you can mess around with this and make it as nice and neat as you want. And now let's go to layer C. We'll do the same thing. Scale her down, bring her to the bottom left. She's a little small. All right, that's looking decent. All right, and then we'll go to layer D and scale that one down and do the same thing, bottom right corner. All right, so cool. We have ourselves a nice little Brady Bunch show here. Hey, check it out. All right, so of course that's not quite perfect. Let's see, you can move layer A down a little bit. Adjust it. All right, sorry. I won't be a perfectionist about this for today's example, but you get the idea. All right, so I went ahead and just did all that. Again, you can adjust the cropping and rotation of these individual shots, but check this out. Here's something even more fun that you can do with this. I was doing all of those layers individually, but I can select all of them at the same time as well. So for example, let's go ahead and just grab 4 fingers, mash on layers A, B, C, and D, and now I have control over all of those layers at the same time. So, for example, I'm going to click on rotation here, and then we can just make them all spin, whee, like this. Go back the other way, reset it. I can adjust all the cropping of them at the same time, too, so I can take up all their left sides, all the right sides, etc., using the exact same controls. I can scale them up and down if I need to, however I want. So that makes things really convenient whenever you want to start adjusting your shots accordingly. And again, play around with these. Do what you want. Make your show look unique. It doesn't have to be a Brady Bunch shot like this. You can flip these things around, have something fun and unique, just depending on how you want to make your show. You are creating art after all, just to remind you. So this stuff is pretty cool and fun to play with. And I highly recommend checking that out. The control panel makes things super convenient and easy to adjust your different shots within your virtual sets or your mix effects. So as you can see, using the control panel to control your mix effect layers is a quick and easy way to make your shots look top-notch. Now, if you like this video and would like to see similar tutorial videos on New Tech products, click subscribe on the New Tech YouTube channel at youtube.com/newtechinc. And for formal New Tech product training, you can sign up for New Tech University, available at newtech.com/newtech-u. And for more information on New Tech products and services, you can contact your local reseller or visit our website at newtech.com. And lastly, if you are sharing your work on social media using New Tech products, tag us. Use the hashtags New Tech or TriCaster, and we'd love to see what y'all are coming up with. So that's all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time for the next edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. Yeah!